Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. This time on Demystifying Research, we will be focusing on lab errors, something we don't see behind the closed doors of a lab. We will also be showing how these errors can have huge impacts in patient care. Clinical labs is a place where doctors send blood, urine, or other samples from the body to be tested in order to obtain information about the health of a patient to aid in diagnosis, treatment, and prevention of disease, though errors in these processes can have significant consequences. So let's first dive into the five main lab errors that can occur in a clinical lab. 1. Pre-analytical errors. These occur before the analysis phase and are the most common type of error in clinical labs. An example of pre-analytical errors is when a blood sample is drawn from a patient without properly labeling the vial. This can lead to confusion about the patient's identity. The second lab error is called analytical errors. These occur during the actual testing and analysis of the sample. An example of this is when a spectrophotometer, a tool used to measure enzyme activity in blood, is not correctly set up right, resulting in inaccurate readings. The third lab error that can occur is post-analytical errors. These occur after testing has been completed. An example of this is when a lab technician correctly identifies elevated glucose levels in a patient's blood, but enters the data into the wrong patient's electronic health record. 4. Human errors can also occur too. These are unintentional actions or omissions made by the healthcare staff. An example of this is when a lab member accidentally switches two patient samples during processing, causing a mix-up in results. 5. System errors can happen too. These are failures within the healthcare system that impact lab work. An example of this is when the lab's result reporting system is outdated and slow, causing delays in critical test results reaching the attending physician. Now, what are the most common causes of these errors in the lab setting? First up, we have human errors. Mistakes in technique or documentation lapses can introduce inaccuracies into our results. Imagine a researcher diligently conducting an experiment, but a simple procedural oversight or a documentation mistake could lead to skewed data. These errors highlight the critical importance of precision and attention to detail in every step of the scientific process. Next on our list are calibration issues and instrumentation failures. Equipment malfunctions may lead to incorrect measurements, jeopardizing the reliability of our findings. Consider a scenario where a spectrophotometer isn't properly calibrated. This could result in inaccurate readings and ultimately flawed conclusions. Lastly, let's talk about contamination. Mishandling of samples or environmental factors can pose a significant risk to the integrity of our results. Picture this, a researcher not wearing gloves during sample handling. Contamination from their hands could introduce foreign elements, skewing the experiment's outcome. As we have seen, while labs strive for precision and accuracy, human errors, calibration issues, and contamination remain persistent challenges. So we must remember that attention to detail is key. Now that we know about how these errors can be made and which steps of the lab process they can occur in, what are the real-life implications? In other words, how can lab errors make an impact on human lives, especially patient lives? Well, imagine you're in a lab conducting a test to diagnose a disease. This is commonly known as a diagnostic test. You want to make sure that your results are as accurate as possible to prevent misdiagnosis, otherwise known as giving someone the wrong diagnosis. These normally happen during the pre-analytical phase we talked about earlier, where most lab errors occur. These common errors can lead to some serious implications, such as being prescribed unsuitable treatments, such as a drug for a condition you do not have, and also delays in crucial medical interventions if you are told your result is considered normal and not positive for a disease. It is therefore very important to consider patient-centered care. This means that patients are involved and thought of in every step of the laboratory phase, especially in that pre-analytical phase, improving the quality of not just laboratory settings, but also ensuring the safety of patients at the core of it all. To ensure accurate results, it wouldn't just be a goal, it would be a commitment to patient safety and public trust. But how can we prevent and reduce errors in the first place? Well, let's begin with cleaning. Cleaning isn't just a task, it's a science. It's about more than just wiping down surfaces. It's understanding the when, how, and what of cleaning, frequency, detergents, and the level of dismantlement required. Comprehensive training ensures every staff member knows the intricacies. Calibration is the heartbeat of precision. It's the fine-tuning that ensures accuracy, repeatability, and standardized results. Regular calibration, whether by in-house experts or trusted third parties, is a non-negotiable. Proper documentation and staff training are imperative for this critical process. Lastly, routine servicing of lab equipment isn't an expense, it's an investment in reliability. Just as cars need tune-ups, lab equipment demands regular checkups too. This proactive approach ensures longevity, especially for intricate or heavily relied upon equipment. Ultimately, understanding how to prevent and reduce lab errors isn't just about catching mistakes, it's about continuous improvement. Providing ongoing training in cleaning, calibration, and vigilant upkeep are important practices in lab management that not only minimizes downtime and costs, but ensures the accuracy of lab results. Join us in our commitment to excellence. Together, we can shape a future where lab errors are minimized and patient outcomes are optimized. Thank you for joining us on this episode of Demystifying Research. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more insights into the world of science. See you next time.